Often, if you're like me, I mean, you and I think we tend to lie about our reality and about the way we feel about our reality. When something goes terribly wrong, we pretend everything's fine. We walk into church with smiling faces, we show up at community group, and we hide the darkest parts of our existence and souls. We're afraid to cry out because it shows our vulnerability and weakness. And so we pretend that everything's fine when it's really broken and wrong. And then, if we get to the point where we can't pretend everything's okay anymore, when reality has really crashed in, then we lie about the way we feel about it, and often we do that through blame. We find somebody else to blame for our problems. Job's friends blamed Job. We often find somebody around us who can take the blame for what's happened to us in life. Our spouse is normally very convenient. We can blame them really easily. Sometimes our kids, we can blame them for the pain in our life. Every mother in the room knows it's always the mother's fault. And so we can blame our parents and the choices that they've made. Some of us, if we can't find someone else to blame, we internalize it. We decide that everything is our fault. We say things like, oh, I've done it again. It's all my fault. I can't do anything right. And Job doesn't do any of this. He maintains his innocence. He believes that everything that's happened to him is undeserved, but that it's real and that it's painful. He expressed his emotions fully, and that's hard for us to do. Daniel Goleman wrote an excellent book about emotional intelligence. And in his book, he identified 8 different categories of emotion that we all experience. He put a name to it. Some of us have a hard time even knowing if we're feeling anything because we've taught ourselves so effectively how to avoid crying out. So I want you to take a look at these different 8 categories of emotion that can help us give a name to what we feel.